It started with an infinitely hot and dense single point that inflated and stretched first at unimaginable speeds, and then at a more measurable rate over the next 13.8 billion years to the still expanding cosmos that we know today. The Big Bang theory is the best model we currently have for the birth of our universe. Astrophysicists have demonstrated that the theory adequately explains phenomena observed in space over decades, such as lingering background radiation and elemental abundance. It's a solid framework that gives us a good idea of how the universe came to be. There has been a flurry of articles and social media posts about the first images from the James Webb Space Telescope, claiming that the Big Bang never happened. According to one scientist, the JWST images are causing panic among cosmologists. This is simply not the case. The JWST has not provided evidence to refute the Big Bang theory, so cosmologists are not concerned. So, why are we seeing viral social media posts and strange headlines claiming that the Big Bang never happened? Where did the Big Bang didn't happen come from? It all started with an article at the Institute of Art and Ideas, a British philosophical organization. The piece was written by Eric Lerner, who has long argued against the Big Bang theory. Lerner's article gained traction on social media, with many people sharing it on Twitter and Facebook. It's easy to see why it's caught fire. It's a divisive idea that calls into question everything we think we know about the universe. Furthermore, it is linked to a new piece of technology in the James Webb Telescope, which is seeing previously unseen parts of the universe. Using Webb as a news hook implies that new data has been discovered that contradicts a long-held theory. The JWST is generating new and interesting data, just not the kind that would cast doubt on the Big Bang theory. Lerner's piece uses early JWST studies to try to disprove the Big Bang theory. What's troubling is how it misinterprets early JWST data to imply that astronomers and cosmologists are concerned that the well-established theory is wrong. There are two points early in Lerner's article which show this. He points to a preprint with the word panic in its title, calling it a candid exclamation. He misuses a quote from Alison Kirkpatrick, an astronomer at the University of Kansas. The first point is just a case of Lerner missing the pun. The full title of the paper is Panic at the Disks: First Rest Frame Optical Observations of Galaxy Structure at Z Greater Than 3 with JWST in the SMACS 0723 field. The first author of that preprint, astronomer Leonardo Ferreira, clearly riffs on the popular 2000s emo band Panic at the Disco with his title. It's a witty reference, not a cosmological crisis. As for the second point, Lerner takes this quote from Alison Kirkpatrick, which comes from a Nature News article published on July 27th. Right now I find myself lying awake at 3 in the morning and wondering if everything I've done is wrong. This selected quote makes no direct reference to the Big Bang theory. Rather, Kirkpatrick is dealing with the first data from the JWST about the universe's early evolution. True, there are some mysteries for astronomers to solve here, but they aren't rewriting the history of the universe to do so. Kirkpatrick has stated that her quotes have been misappropriated, and she has even changed her Twitter handle to Alison the Big Bang Happened Kirkpatrick. Why does this matter? Because current technology does not allow astronomers to literally peer back into the universe's birth. Much of what we know about the Big Bang is based on mathematical formulas and models. Astronomers, on the other hand, can see the echo of the expansion via a phenomenon known as the cosmic microwave background. The cosmic microwave background, or CMB, is leftover radiation from the Big Bang or the time when the universe began. You can't see the CMB with your naked eye, but it is everywhere in the universe. It is invisible to humans because it is so cold. This means its radiation is most visible in the microwave part of the electromagnetic spectrum. According to NASA, CMB fills the universe, and in the days before cable TV, every household with television could see the afterglow of the Big Bang by turning the television to the in-between channel. You could see the CMB as a static signal on the screen, so to bolster evidence the Big Bang theory is incorrect, you'd need to explain the CMB another way. Lerner's dismissive of the CMB and his proposal for the observation has been disproven in the past. If you're interested in further arguments against Lerner's hypotheses and why the claims don't add up, I recommend checking out Brian Keating's recent YouTube video. Keating is a cosmologist at the University of California and dives into a bit more detail about the limits of Lerner's arguments. It's also worth noting that Webb was not designed to see and conduct new analysis of the CMB. The telescope cannot see that far back in time. It will, however, look at a time period a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. What it discovers there will almost certainly alter our understanding of the early universe, galaxies, and the evolution of the universe. However, it is deceptive to claim that early images and study results contradicted the Big Bang theory. The irony is that JWST's observations are actually supporting the Big Bang model, showing that the first galaxies were smaller and grew larger over time, just as Big Bang cosmology predicts. The surprising finding that galaxies in the early universe are more plentiful and a little more massive and structured than expected doesn't mean that the Big Bang is wrong. It just means that some of the cosmology that follows the Big Bang requires a little bit of tweaking. That is the appeal of science. Despite the claims of Lerner and other science denialists, science is never black and white. We're always learning, always improving our theories. It's much easier to make a sensational, attention-grabbing claim than it is to go through the full suite of evidence and draw a responsible, scientifically accurate conclusion.